everybody. I'm Larry Ridley. You're tuned in to the NFL on EA Sports. Two running backs will take the field today in hopes of leading their team to victory out on that field. It's Ingram's Packers going up against Freeman's Falcons.
All right, Larry, thank you very much. It's the National Football League. EA Sports. A moment ago, here was the scene. The Falcons coming out from their tunnel to the roar of all the folks here in England.
Oh, what the fuck is
football as these Falcons get set to match up with the Green Bay Packers. That's fielded in the end zone.
Great, now I can't see.
Oh, what a move. And he'll take it back to about the 19-yard line. And it'll be second down.
And him running the football is not something that defenses spend a lot of time preparing for. But this guy has a survival instinct and a knack for knowing when exactly to do it.
And a former Heisman winner. This is Mark Ingram. And he'll get this one up to the 26. Opening drive as they're looking at a third and three. Brady gonna try and throw on third down. Got a man. It's his tight end, Lance Kendricks. And he's gonna have the first down at about the 38. 12 yards there as they move the chains.
Oh, you dumbass.
And now some motion before the snap. And this will be our first penalty of the night's proceedings. Throwing now is Brady. He gets it complete to Anquan Boldin. And he'll be brought down right at the 45-yard line. 12 yards on back-to-back plays there, and that's another first down. On second down, Ingram, and a minimal gain here as he's up to about the 47-yard line. Just a couple on the pickup there, and now it's third down.
One thing that I observed when Dante Fowler was coming out in the NFL draft, how hard he played the game. Every time I turned on a tape, he was either rushing the passer or making a play, or making a play in space against a ball downfield, or hustling from one sideline to the other. How about that play right there? Making a nice tackle, holding it to a short gain.
To throw is Brady. He's got his man on the crossing route. And he's got the first down yardage before he's brought down at the 42.
Oh, no.
A handoff. It's Mark Ingram.
Damn it.
And they went the wrong way there. Losing yard. Back at the 43-yard line. On second down, here's Brady. That's complete to his tight end. This is Lance Kendricks. him a new set of downs. On first and 10, here's Brady. Inside the 10. That is caught right at the 10-yard line. Chewing up big yardage. Another nice gain there. This one goes for 20.
Okay, I'm not so great at math. I just looked over at our statistician, Marvin, and he signaled to me 5 for 5 to get things started here on this opening drive. Where I come from, that's pretty good.
That is pretty good. Now, what do you do defensively to adjust?
Well, this is where you got to make a decision as your defensive as a defensive coordinator. Do you really get after the quarterback? Or maybe you can get on the receivers, buck the ball for their routes, chip away at their timing so things aren't as precise as they've been in so far.
A really long drive here, and it goes on and on. Brady to throw on second down. That's going to be caught at the 10-yard line.
God damn it.
And he'll get blown up behind the line of scrimmage, back at the 6. It'll be a loss of a yard, and that'll make it 3rd and goal.
Oh, come on.
This team is not going to make it easy for you. They're a physical group, and we just saw there on that play. It came in, made the contact, just as he's trying to haul it in.
And the 10-year vet knocks it through the goalpost, and the Packers are off to a 3-0 lead. So they get 3. They were hoping for 6. And unlucky number 13 played.
How are you?
Well, you go to the sideline after putting 3 points on the board. Happy, but you wanted to be ecstatic. You wanted to have 6 on the board. On the opposite sideline, though, the defense, I think they're high-fiving each other, only giving up 3 after letting them run that much offense. Shit, I can run right back too. Good pick.
Picked off near the 26, and they will take over at the 26-yard line. He had a little bit of the turnover bug last week, 3 interceptions. Not an absolute disaster, but another one here. Do you start to get a little worried?
You worry about your team as a whole because you have to find a way to make those interceptions quote-unquote go away, and that means your defense. They've got to go out there on sudden change and at least hold people to field goals. And if that keeps happening, they lose confidence in the quarterback, and then no one plays well.
We haven't seen much from him running the football here in this first quarter. No, you're right.
So far, they stacked him up pretty well, but when you're trying to run the football, sometimes you've got to play the long game.
Whoa, where are you throwing it? Brady?
They turn into 6, 7, 8, and maybe later on.
Randall Cobb, the intended receiver, and it's 3rd down. And the offense looking to pick up the 1st down after the 2nd down incompletion. Throwing is Brady on 3rd down.
Why?
Fires one, but incomplete.
Are you?
I'm going to raise my voice a little bit here because one thing we can already tell, even in the first year in the league,
where
this new stadium,
fuck,
it's going to get loud in this place.
Yeah, the old place was loud, but I think we're getting a sense that this place is going to be louder.
Yeah, they're riding that momentum of that 2016 team that finished their year in the Super Bowl.
He gets us away. It's a good one. Drawing toward the sidelines. And this will carry out of bounds. Where are they going to spot it now? At about the 18-yard line, it looks like.
Twice he threw behind the motherfucker.
Last drive they'd like to emulate, and of course they'd like to forget the ending, the interception, but they did put together, Charles, a nice sustained drive to get him down the field.
Yeah, don't understand that.
The only thing that matters is part two, right? Because once they threw the interception and finished off the drive, that does a no good.
Are you kidding? I was about to say.
Finish things off. That's the only way you can get it done.
And a nice gain at 21 yards.
To win any route, you've got to break down the defender. And that's exactly what happened here on this really nicely executed curl route.
And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down. So he can't hang on. And as I watch that unfold, I remembered an expression that I've heard, maybe from you, I don't know. He's my as well hold on to the ball.
Well, you know a coach said that, right? Yeah. Not an actual player. No chance at all. Way easier said than done.
According to the head linesman, incomplete. So the ball a little late getting there, and it's third down. So still a full 10 yards to go here for the offense on third down. Timeout coming from the defensive side for the pass.